stage, Dean Bo Moskowitz.
One more 170-pound matchup tonight. Welterweight Dean Bo Moskowitz makes his way to the cage. The 18-year-old stands at 5'8" tall. He just finished his freshman year at Cal State Northridge. This is his debut fight, fighting out of Encino, California, with House of Champions and Aziz MMA. Dean Bo is an Israeli, first-generation Israeli. Recently participated in the Susan G. Komen Walk for the Cure, the breast cancer benefit in support of many members of his family. He's been doing judo and karate since he was 4 years old. Started training mixed martial arts specifically at 14 years old. He currently teaches mixed martial arts for children at Pierce Junior College on the weekends. He says he's here to test his skills. He thinks he has an advantage everywhere in the fight. Says that whatever his opponent Darien Mathews gives him, he's gonna take. When he's not here, he likes to spend time with his family and just relax.
That's important too. After hard training, that's what you want, is relax.
Dean Moskowitz, a bit of background in Krav Maga. Krav Maga, again, the art of hitting the knees, the nose, the neck, and the junk.
Yes.
A lot of Krav Maga techniques not legal in the cage, since a lot of Krav Maga techniques are designed to, you know, fracture your larynx or end your life.
Yes, Krav Maga has great self-defense, especially for special forces, but you can't use those techniques in the competition.
Yeah, one thing we do not allow here at the U, and that's death blows. We've done our best to ensure that our fighters don't die. Hence why we have no matches against lions.
It would be spectacular, though.
That it would.
Let's welcome his opponent making his way to the cage, Darien Mathews.
Dean Bo's opponent coming to the cage now in the blue corner, Darien Mathews. The 25-year-old's an orthodox fighter, also making his debut out of Torrance, California, fights with Brood 9 martial arts. He's a second-degree Taekwondo black belt. He's been doing Hapkido for 4 years, Muay Thai 3 years, and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Now, what is it from Taekwondo that translates best to the cage?
You know, Taekwondo fighters, they have excellent kicks, and they can kick from all kinds of angles. So even Taekwondo fighter is able to keep his distance, that's when they're really dangerous. Using those legs from far, usually very quick, very explosive, and with both legs.
Darien Mathews hasn't won any fights yet, but he does win the award tonight for having one of the cheesiest walkout songs of the evening. You know, I'm annoyed because I thought I was the best around.
He'll be happy to hear that.
Darien Mathews getting looked over by our cage side referee, checking to make sure that there's no chalk dust hidden in his wrist so he can't blind him like Van Damme within a blood sport. Kumite, kumite, kumite. We don't allow that in the cage either. Let's just go through all the things that we don't allow here in the U of MMA. No weapons?
No weapons, no.
Although we're currently lobbying the state government, no, we're not.
This next fight is brought to you by Southern California Crossroads. Fight is scheduled for 3 2-minute rounds in the 170-pound division. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, making his debut. He stands at 5'8" tall and weighing at 167 pounds, representing Aziz Mixed Martial Arts and House of Champions from Encino, California, Dean Bo. And his opponent across the cage, fighting out of the blue corner. A freestyle fighter also making his debut. He stands at 5'9" tall and weighing at 163.4 pounds. Fighting with a Brood 9 martial arts from Torrance, California, Darien Mathews. In charge of the action, Jen Takos.
In the blue corner, Darien Mathews. Dean Bo Moskowitz in the red corner. Round one of this welterweight fight. Here we go. Darien Mathews comes out
and
quickly,
it is over.
But Dean Bo cracks him. That's it. That was a great right hand. The referee is trying to break it up, but wow. I don't actually know what to say about that one. Darien Mathews got cracked quickly. The referee jumped in to break him off, but Dean Bo was, I think he looked like he was under, like Darien Mathews was fighting back after the ref jumped in.
Yeah, but some fighters are fighting back autopilot. They're out, they don't know what's going on, they're still moving. But it doesn't mean they're fighting. Dean Bo didn't listen to the referee. He should have stepped back and let the referee deal with that. Yeah, this is interesting to see what the judges are gonna do with this.
We'll get that replay one more time in a moment. Darien Mathews bleeding heavily from the face. He came in very aggressive. Let's get a second look at that. That big right hand catches and drops Darien Mathews. Dean Bo jumps out on the referee very far away, jumps in to grab Dean Bo. Didn't get to see the rest of that tussle there. Couldn't really tell. It looked like Dean was still being pretty aggressive. I'm not sure if Darien Mathews knew the fight was over.
I'm not sure either.
You know, look at that one more time here. Again, Darien coming in very aggressive, gets caught immediately on the chin. Good right cross.
It was the first punch, and it was pretty much over, and it was a good call from the referee.
So you can see here's Darien Mathews grabbing for that underhook.
He was still grabbing, he was holding on, but I doubt that he knew what he was doing.
So a bit of excitement here, not just the knockout, not just the cut, but a little bit of extra action there to sprinkle on the end, a nice garnish. You know, but you know, you're not supposed to eat the garnish. That's the one problem.
I do think, though, that it was a good call by the referee. She stepped in early, but it's amateur. And those guys come out, it's their debut fight. And they have to be protected. It has to be safe. It was a good call, but yeah, it was a little bit...
Here we get one more look at it. You're going to see after that punch. Watch Darien Mathews just go... He does curl up, but he goes kind of flat on his stomach here for a second.
He's struggling. He is moving.
And there we go. See, we have Dean Bo trying to create space. I think Dean seems like he backed off early enough. I just don't think Darien Mathews knew that the referee had jumped in yet.
No. I think the ball didn't know that the referee jumped in. She came from a different angle. She came from behind Dean Bo's weird angle. He couldn't see the referee, but.
Dean Bo wrapping himself in the blue and white of Israel, the Kachol V'Lavan in the native Hebrew. The Israeli fighter has to be happy with himself. Not a lot of emotion on his face. Dean Bo is a very quiet man, very reserved, but not so much with his fists.
No, it was an amazing right hand, a really good right cross, right on the chin. Darien Mathews stepped in and Dean Bo caught him.
You know, taking a while here for the official decision, wondering if the referees might be trying to decide. Not much to really decide here. The guy got punched in the face really hard.
He got punched in the face. He was the better fighter, that's clearly. I think that Darien Mathews might have been knocked out, but when he hit the floor, maybe it woke him up. That happens sometimes. On the other hand, the athletic commissions are very strict that if you don't listen to the referees, they might disqualify you. So we'll see what's going to happen here.
Dean Bo speaking with his father. His father moved here from Israel. Don't know exactly how long ago. There we go. Now we get a smile from the young fighter. Now starting to show some pretty strong emotion. Getting a high five from a guy with an earring. I didn't know we were still doing that. I thought that was the 90s.
I don't know either. For me, it was the 80s.
For me, it was never because my mom would have kicked my butt.
Oh, okay.
I nearly made the mistake in college of getting the cuff on the upper part of the ear, the cuff up here on the cartilage.
Oh, wow.
But I'm very glad I avoided that.
Yes.
Just like I never wore tie-dye. I'm very happy about both of those two things. Well, as we go through the hits of the 80s and the 90s here from our DJ, still waiting to find out what our judges are going to say. Let's get one more look at that replay. Darien comes in, left hand low. Look at that. He tries to throw that, that left hook. Just gets caught right across the jaw. You know, Dean's not throwing any strikes here. I think he's just trying to keep distance. Darien Mathews is going, what? I don't know what happened.
Yeah, he doesn't remember that he got knocked down and probably knocked out for a second. And even though he woke up after he hit the floor, he was out for a second. And it was a good call by the referee.
You know, we didn't get to see a lot here from Dean Bowe tonight. But I think this young 18-year-old fighter has a strong future, a good show of support and sportsmanship. Darien Mathews doing the same. You know, it shows a lot of class when you can get clocked like that and still show your opponent that much respect.
Yes. Yes, great guys. And both still young, both with a big future, possibly.
A right cross like that from an 18-year-old. I'd hate to see what he's doing at 25.
Yeah, it showed a great, what I call distance control. He saw Darien Mathews coming in and he caught him. He just didn't thought about it. He just threw the right hand.
So what's it like getting your first win, especially being a young man like that? Do you remember your first win and how you felt?
Yes, I still remember that. That's great. You've been training for so long. You've been training for years, and not just the weeks leading up to the fight. We already been training for a few years, and you know you want to know where you're at. You want to know, you know, you want to measure yourself through competition, see what level you are, and then when you have the first win, it feels great.
Darien Mathews now exiting the cage to go get looked at. That cut was dripping pretty heavily. Still have a little bit of brown stains on the mat from where the blood is beginning to dry. Darien talking with camo officials. Still holding that towel up there. He haven't gotten a good look yet at that cut, but hopefully he'll bring it down and we can see the handiwork of young Dean Bowe Moskowitz.
It looked like a deep one to me. And that's why he's holding the towel there, I guess, to stop the bleeding.
You know, my favorite Moskowitz moment was when he ran up the chains and got into the boat and then sang to... Sorry, that's Moskowitz. I was thinking of an American Tale. I was totally off there. I misinterpreted if it was Moskowitz or Moskowitz.
That's fine. It happens.
I know. It's a very easy thing. A young fighter with a big right cross or a cartoon mouse? Which one? And now to finally hear our official decision. Oh, bit of a false start here. Judges are still conferring. Big John McCarthy and Cecil Peebles are speaking to Dean Bowe's father. Dean Bowe's father looks a little upset, gesturing pretty heavily. And now coming to the cage, Salvador Arellano entering to give us our official judge's decision on the fight.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the fight ends at 5 seconds of the first round. Fighter out of the red corner is disqualified for disobeying an official's order. Your winner out of the blue corner by disqualification, Darien Mathews!
Darien Mathews shaking his head as the camera comes in. Not happy to win a fight like that. Must be tough for the young fighter, Dean Bowe Moskowitz. I don't think he was intentionally disobeying any referee. Love to see these referees get a look at the replay. Very tough for the young kid. But I think that Dean still has a bright future ahead of him.
Absolutely. He's a great fighter, great athlete. He showed his skills, but he didn't stop when the referee told him to. And
they take it very serious
here with Kimo.
I'm doing okay.
The safety of the fighters is very important. And these are amateurs. They're not professionals. They're not paid a lot of money. They're amateurs working their ways up.
The fighters have to follow the rules, but I really did feel like he won that fight. I mean, he knocked me out. It was my fault I didn't defend myself. So I really feel like he won it. Even though he didn't follow the rules, I do understand the organization's call on it.
A great display of sportsmanship. Darien Mathews, ladies and gentlemen.